Peter has always been very much against violence. I was in a very violent relationship, and it hurt him deep inside to see me with bruises on my face or on my body. And he always spoke badly about people that would do violent acts, man or female. He didn't want anybody to do violent things to anybody else. He loved bumblebees, you know. He had a little area in the back of his workshop that he called Mr. Bumblebee's Garden, where he would sit and look at the flowers and the bumblebees. It really doesn't fit in my view of a killer. Never. I've changed my mind many times during this whole thing. And now I'm sort of leaning towards that Peter was under a lot of stress, and I think he lost touch with himself and with reality. And I think he did some things that was really out of his normal nature. And I think he's really having a hard time with it himself. And I think what truly happened, we will never know. It's something in between the very bad picture and the accident that, of course, didn't happen, you know? It's somewhere in between. It's really hard for me because I've been shifting so much during this time, and then believing this, and I was believing that maybe he could have killed me, and all these really horrible thoughts. But then, for all these years I knew Peter, I never, ever, ever, not once felt in any way that he was capable of doing this. So I'm really not convinced about this ice-cold killer story. I'm not. It's been really rough for me, all this. This emotional stress has been some of the hardest I've ever experienced in my life, and I've been through a lot. And this is it. I've lost like 7 kilos, I've been depressed, I've been drinking. I've had a horrible time, really. And it's like, now I know that he will get the verdict, but then he can appeal, and it's like it's not going to end for me tomorrow. I love him still, simply because I still love him and I always will. Peter was a really, really great person to me. He did a lot of fantastic things for me. And he was very tender. One time I had 2 broken arms. And Peter came every morning on his way to work to brush my long hair. He was a really fantastic, good person. He always helped me out. He was always there for me. So yeah, I love Peter and I always will. And nobody can take it away from me. Nobody. And I'm not concerned about what people think about it. If they don't like me because I still have love for Peter, then that's their problem, not mine.